Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss the new topic, definite integral. As we know, there are two types of integral, that is indefinite integral and definite integral. Indefinite integral has some limits. There we get only the simplest form of the function, but definite integral, it has some limits. We can get the exact solution of the function. Now we will see the few examples. The first one, evaluate the definite integral, integral minus 1 to 1 x plus 1 into dx. We need to integrate, let I equal to integral minus 1 to 1 x plus 1 into dx. The given function has two term, then separate that function, then we get integral minus 1 to 1 x into dx plus integral minus 1 to 1 into dx. Then integrate the first function, we get x squared by 2 close bracket minus 1 to 1 plus integrate the second one 1 dx, we can get x minus 1 to 1. Then we'll replace the upper limit and lower limit in that function. X we has upper limit 1, then we'll replace 1 squared by 2 minus, this is the formula, minus minus 1 squared, the lower limit is minus 1, that's what, minus 1 squared by 2 plus the second function also will replace the upper limit and lower limit. Then upper x will replace upper limit 1 minus, then lower limit will replace that. Then minus 1 minus of minus 1, then reduce this 1, we get 1 by 2 minus, that minus 1 squared is 1, then 1 by 2 plus 1 minus minus plus 1, then we'll reduce this 1, we get minus 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 will be cancel each other, then 1 plus 1 equal to 2. 2 is the answer. The next one, evaluate the definite integral, integral 4 to 5 e power x dx. We need to integrate, let I equal to integral of 4 to 5 e power x dx. Integration of e power x dx, we get e power x, 4 to 5 is the limit. Then limit we can substitute in that function, e power 5 minus e power 4 we get. Then reduce this one, we get e power 4 is the common factor, we can take e power 4 into e power 5, we have e minus 1, that is the answer. Next one, evaluate the definite integral, integral 0 to 1 x into e power x squared dx. We need to integrate I equal to integral of 0 to 1 x into e power x squared dx. This one we need to integrate by substitution method. X squared we can assume t, then differentiate this one, we get differentiation with respect to x, we get 2x into dx equal to dt. Reduce this one, x into dx equal to dt by 2. Then we can change the limit in terms of t, then x equal to 0, x 0 value we can replace in this function, t also will get 0. Then upper limit 1, then x equal to 1 it can take, then replace in that function, then t we get 1. Then we change it in terms of t limit also. Therefore, I equal to integral of 0 to 1. Next, e power x squared. X squared we know t, then replace e power t. Then x into dx we have dt by 2, then replace this one dt by 2. can reduce this integration value 1 by 2 into integral of 0 to 1 e power t into dt. Then integrate this one, we get 1 by 2 e power t, integration of e power t is e power t. Then we can write e power t limit value 0 to 1. Then we can apply the limit value in that function 1 by 2 into e power 1 minus e power 0. Then reduce this one, 1 by 2 e power 1 is e, e power 0 then 1. This is the answer. The next one, evaluate the definite integral, integral of 0 to 1, 1 by square root of 1 minus x squared into dx. Then we need to integrate I equal to integral 0 to 1, 1 by square root of 1 minus x squared into dx. This is the given integral value. Then we can integrate 1 by square root of 1 minus x squared dx, we know that is sine inverse of x. Then we can integrate this one, sine inverse of x 0 to 1 we get. Then we can apply the upper limit and lower limit in that function. Then we get sine inverse of 1 minus sine inverse of 0. Then again we can reduce this one, sine inverse of 1 we can write sine pi by 2. Why no? Because sine 1 equal to sine pi by 2. Then sine inverse of 0 we can write sine 0. Why no? Because 0 we can have sine 0 is 0. Then we can reduce this one, pi by 2 minus sine 0 is 0, then minus 0 equal to, then we get pi by 2. Therefore integral of 0 to 1, 1 by square root of 1 minus x squared into dx equal to pi by 2. This is the answer. The next one, evaluate the integral, integral 0 to 1 x by x squared plus 1 into dx using the substitution method. We need to integrate the given function. Let I equal to integral 0 to 1 x by x squared plus 1 into dx. We can go for substitution method. X squared plus 1 we can assume t, then differentiate with respect to x, then we get x squared 2x, then differentiation of 1 is 0, then we get differentiation of t, we can write it as dt by dx, then reduce this one, x into dx equal to dt by 2. Then we can change the limit also, then x equal to 0, we can replace in that function, then x 0, this term should be 0, then t equal to 1, we can replace here. Then upper limit 1, we can take x equal to 1, we can replace in that function, then x we can 1 replace, then 1 squared plus 1 equal to t, then therefore t equal to 2 we get. Then limit also we changed, then therefore we get I equal to integral of 1 to 2 1 by t into dt by 2. Then 1 by 2 is the constant value, we can take out, then write 1 by 2 into integral of 1 to 2 1 by t into dt. Then 1 by 2, then integration of 1 by t into dt is log mod t limit 1 to 2. Then we can replace the upper limit and lower limit in that function, we get 1 by 2 into log 2 minus log 1. Then reduce this one, 1 by 2 into log 2, then we can get 1 by 2 into log 2. Then 1 by 2 minus log 1, we know log 1 is 0, then the next term, the second term is 0, we get I equal to 1 by 2 log 2. This is the answer. The next one, evaluate the integral minus 1 to 1, 1 by x squared plus 2x plus 5 using the substitution. We need to integrate that I equal to integral minus 1 to 1, 1 by x squared plus 2x plus 5 into dx. Then given polynomial will reduce, we get x squared plus 2x plus 5, can reduce x squared plus 2x, the 5 we can write 1 plus 4. Then x squared plus 2x plus 1 is nothing but x plus 1 whole squared plus the 4 we can change and write 2 squared. Then we can replace in that integral, we can get I equal to integral of minus 1 to 1, 1 by x plus 1 squared plus 2 squared into dx. Then we can go for the substitution method, reducing this integral. Then x plus 1 equal to t, then differentiate with respect to x, then we get dx equal to dt. Now change the limit also, x equal to minus 1, then t equal to 0. Then x equal to plus 1, then t we get 1 plus 1, t equal to 2. Then replace here, t equal to 0 to 2 we get. Then we'll apply the limit also. Therefore, I equal to integral of 0 to 2, 1 by x plus 1, we can replace t, then t squared plus 4 we can change and write t squared. Then dx is nothing but dt, we can replace here. Now integrate this integral value. Now we know that 1 by x squared plus a squared dx equal to 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus c is the formula. We can replace here, we can get 1 by 2 tan inverse of t by 2 limit 0 to 2. Then we can apply the limits 1 by 2 tan inverse of t, we can replace 2 t by 2 minus lower limit we can apply 1 by 2 tan inverse of 0 by 2. Then reduce this 1 by 2 tan inverse of 1, this term 0 will eliminate. Then we get 1 by 2 tan inverse of tan, 1 is nothing but 10 by 5 4. Then we will replace here, we get 1 by 2 into 5 by 4. Then reduce this 1, we get 5 by 8. Then therefore I equal to 5 by 8, this is the answer.